Guys, how you doing? Sean Snyder, John here, coming to you from the floor. I want to talk today about a great ab exercise called leg raises. You probably have heard about them. I've been working on these for the last couple weeks. I haven't touched them in a very long time. First heard about them in convict conditioning as a progression to hanging leg raises on the pull-up bar. And it's just a great exercise. I actually like to do them on the bed. And I want to share with you a tip that increased my reps by 20. And I haven't done these in a long time, so I had my previous maximum like PR, personal record, and I started doing them again, and I increased it by 20. And I was kind of thinking like, wow, that's a lot. What have I been doing lately? And I haven't been doing too much. The holidays, I really didn't exercise as much as I should have. So I was wondering where this sudden increase in strength in this lift. And the anterior chain linked exercises helped this summer. All those books that I did this summer on pull-ups and the anterior exercises, those were helpful. But recently over the holidays, and I think this is really what did it, I did a very, very powerful ab exercise every other day. And actually, I do this exercise in my car, like on the way home from work. And there's like a laying down version like this, and there's a sitting down version. And I did the sitting down version. So if you're sitting in the back, if you're sitting in your car seat, if you're driving, okay, this exercise is so easy to do, accessible, but it's extremely powerful. It really strengthens your abs. It's crazy. Abs, if you followed my work, you know that abs are essential part of your training. And you might be trying to get a six pack, or you might just exercise for fun, whatever. But abs are basically the foundation of lower back health. You have the hip stuff, and then you have your abs. And basically, the abs stabilize your lower back. And the strongest contraction that I know of is very easy to do. You sit down, you lay down on the ground, and you just push your lower back as hard as you can. Don't hold back anything. Push it back like you're trying to pulverize the floor. Do not hold anything back. Crush the floor with your lower back. And feel your abs just go crazy. Do it so strongly that you can only do it for about 5 seconds. So really don't hold anything back. And then when you're driving home after work, you're sitting at this traffic light, you're bored, and all of a sudden just push the lower back into the lower part of your car seat. And you'd be surprised. It really wakes you up, and it really gets a strong ab contraction. So that's really the only stuff I've been doing in the ab department. And so the hanging leg, the leg raise exercise, it's the same thing. You want to push your lower back into the surface. So you want to feel your abs contracting throughout the entire exercise. You don't want to feel it in your hip flexors. Maybe the last couple reps, but for the majority of your sets, you want your abs to be stabilizing your lower back, and increase that by pushing them into the floor. But I strongly recommend doing just the strong ab contraction without the leg raises first. Feel the strongest ab contraction you can do, and it should be so almost violent that you can only do it for like 5 seconds. So if you've been doing the leg raise exercise, do the 5 second contraction and then do the leg raises and see if your reps improved. I'm not joking, mine went up by 20. So it's pretty powerful stuff. So I'll be seeing you on the next video. Going to talk a little bit about